game. I love my job, even though the job that I do on the court, people don't like. They don't want to do it. But I love what I'm doing. I want to earn my money. I want to earn my respect on the court.
Making the NBA was a long shot for Dennis Rodman. All right, before we get into this story, if you guys are new here, hit that subscribe button and turn on post notifications to stay updated on new videos. Let's get into it. Dennis Rodman was born in New Jersey and grew up in the Dallas area in Oak Cliff. This was a pretty rough neighborhood. His father left him when he was only 3 years old. A fun fact about his father, he fathered 25 other kids other than Dennis. Just let that sink in. Anyways, his father leaving the family made it tough on Rodman's mom, as she had to take care of him and his two older sisters. Rodman did not have the best childhood growing up. Eventually, he started playing basketball at a nearby gym with his sisters, and this was his escape. He was always a shy kid, which is hard to believe, and he was short and unathletic. The thought of Rodman actually making the NBA, let alone being such an impactful player, was nearly impossible. No one would have ever thought basketball was in his future, and at that time in his life, he probably didn't either. In his freshman year, he was a skinny 5'6 kid who got cut from both the basketball and football teams. Over the next few years, he did make the basketball team, but he was the furthest thing from a star. He rode the bench for most of the games, and after high school, he took on a janitor job at Dallas-Fort Worth Airport. He was just an average guy, but all this changed for him when he was 20 years old. He hit a crazy growth spurt and went from being 5'9" to 6'8". At this point, he knew he shouldn't be a janitor and he should be on the court. So friends and family noticed this too, and a family friend actually told the coach of Cook County College's basketball team, which is now known as North Central Texas College, about Rodman. This was a community college. He ended up playing there for a semester and averaged just over 19 points per game, but he flunked out. After this, Southeastern Oklahoma State offered him a scholarship, and Rodman obviously took it. This school was part of the NAIA, which stands for National Association of Intercollegiate Athletics. He was living at the college that first summer he was there and coaching a camp where he met an 11-year-old kid named Brian Rich. Brian was short compared to the other kids at the camp, so Rodman liked his hustle and the two got along well. On the last day of camp, Brian actually asked Rodman to come over for dinner. This caught him off guard. So remember, Brian is 11 and he tells his parents he's bringing home a friend for dinner. And that friend turns out to be Rodman, who's 22 years old, 6'8", and black in a town where not many black people are living. This is a complete surprise for Brian's parents. Rodman ended up staying the night and he was with that family for 4 years after that. Dennis killed it at Southeastern as soon as he got there. He was an All-American for 3 straight seasons. His first game, he had 42-20, and over the next 3 years, he averaged 26-16. He packed the gym every night. In 1986, Rodman led his team to the NAIA Final Four. NBA scouts took notice, and for the upcoming season, the Detroit Pistons drafted him with the 27th pick in the second round. Remember, at this point, Rodman was also 25 years old, so this was a really risky pick. Chuck Daly, the Pistons' head coach at the time, took a chance with him, and it worked out. Dennis fit in with what we know as the Bad Boy Pistons, and that was the start to his NBA career. In 1993, following the retirement of Daly, Rodman's relationship with the Pistons organization wasn't the best, and he was traded to the Spurs. Before 95-96, Rodman was traded again, and this time to the Bulls, where he'd go on to team up with Michael Jordan and Scottie Pippen to win 3 championships in a row. After Chicago, Rodman signed with the Lakers for a little run in the 99 season, and he ended his playing career the following year with the Mavericks. So all in all, Rodman finished his NBA career with 5 NBA championships, 2 All-Stars, and 2 Defensive Player of the Year awards.
I wanted this award so bad.
In 2011, he was inducted into the NBA Hall of Fame. And that, for you guys, is the Dennis Rodman story, from airport janitor to NBA star.